So hello students, today I'm going to present to you the review and strategy for the chapter current electricity. This video will be useful for students of both CBSE board as well as other state boards who are following the NCERT textbook. So for CBSE students as well as for students who are from Assam High Secondary Education Board, this chapter current electricity, it carries 7 marks, so there will be 2 questions of 2 marks and 1 question of 3 marks. This is as per their blueprint for the question paper. Now this chapter starts with the flow of electric current in conductors. So there you have this role of electric field. Now that is the role of electric field for the motion of charge. So as we know that in a conductor, the current flows when there is a potential difference. Now this potential difference will be set up when there is an electric field. So this, how this electric field is responsible for the motion of electrons, that is given in the first part of the chapter. Then you have the Ohm's law. Now Ohm's law, it is expressed in two forms. V is proportional to I, that is the potential difference is proportional to current, and strength of electric field is proportional to the current density. So these are the two forms of Ohm's law, and the proportionality condition is that the physical conditions are constant, temperature, pressure, those things are constant. The other relations which you need to understand is this R is proportional, R is equal to rho L by A. Rho is the resistivity. Now there are two relations between this R and L. Now in case a wire is stretched, for such kind of problems you have to use R1 by R2 equal to L1 square by L2 square. See, from this expression it appears that R is proportional to L. But R is proportional to L when area is constant. So if area is constant, then you have to use R1 by R2 equal to L1 by L2. But if you stretch a wire, the area will decrease. So in that case, you have to use R1 by R2 equal to L1 square by L2 square. Then you have this drift velocity. So drift velocity expression is Vd equal to minus Ee tau by m. Tau is the average relaxation time. Now as you can see, Vd is a vector quantity. Here electric field is a vector quantity, and you have a minus sign. The minus sign denotes that the electrons, the drift velocity of the electrons is opposite to the direction of electric field. Electrons are negatively charged, obviously they will drift opposite to the direction of electric field. Then you have mobility. Mobility is ratio of magnitude of drift velocity per unit electric field. Then after this you have limitations of Ohm's law. So limitations of Ohm's law is basically, see, the Ohm's law, it gives a direct relationship, proportionality relationship between voltage and current. So these two quantities are directly proportional, so graph between them will be a straight line. Now limitation of Ohm's law means there are various conductors, the non-ohmic conductors, for which you have a non-linear graph. The relation between voltage and current is non-linear. Now after this you have this color code of resistors, identification of resistors based on colors, and then in the same topic you have types of resistors. Then you have temperature dependence of resistors, how the resistivity of resistivity changes with temperature with regard to conductors, semiconductors, alloys, and you have to draw a proper graph. And there is a mathematical relation also which connects resistivity with temperature, that is rho equal to m by n e square tau. Now then we have electrical power. Electrical power, consumption of power in series, consumption of power in parallel. Then you have combination of resistors or grouping of resistors. So you have series grouping of resistors, parallel grouping of resistors. Now that is, in series grouping of resistors there is a division of potential. Potential is divided. In parallel grouping of resistors there is a division of current. Then you have EMF, TPD, terminal potential difference, internal resistance. These terms are associated with this, that is cell. Now you have to understand the relation between EMF, TPD, internal resistance, both during charging as well as charging cell and discharging cell. Then you have to study about grouping of cells, cells in series, cells in parallel, and then mixed grouping of cells. And then you have to identify the condition for maximum current for each grouping. Then you have very important topic, Kirchhoff's law. So you have to understand the law. It is just not enough if you by heart the law. These laws, normally they don't ask the laws. They will ask the implication of the laws, implications, and then applications of the laws. Then you have Wheatstone bridge principle, and then the meter bridge, which works on Wheatstone bridge principle. You may be asked questions based on this meter, which also some questions are given in your NCERT textbook. Then you have potentiometer, advantage of potentiometer over voltmeter, the working principle of potentiometer, applications. Two applications, comparison of EMF of cells and determination of internal resistance of cell. So these are the things you need to revise in this chapter, current electricity. I will also put the important questions examples as well as the questions at the back of this chapter, which from the NCERT textbook, which are all important questions. I will give those questions in the description box. You can check those questions and you should practice them. And with regard to those important questions, I am not saying that only you need to study all those questions. Only those questions you must study. You need to study all the questions as and given the NCERT, but you must give importance, more importance to these questions. Now, I guess with this this strategy, means if you keep these topics in mind and if you revise, I hope it will you'll be able to revise these topics within half an hour to 45 minutes time. So I guess this will be beneficial for you.